Feeling like taking a coffee break? So do I. What about we talk about JEP 409, about sealed classes? This JEP is part of the Happy JEP, scheduled to be released in JDK 17 in September 2021. So, starting with the JDK 17, you will be able to use the sealed classes as a regular feature of Java SE, which is great. So, what are sealed classes about? First, a precision: sealed classes cover concrete classes, abstract classes, and interfaces. It's not just about classes. As usual, the JEP 409, and you should read it, begins by setting its goals and its non-goals. Let us start with the goals. We have three goals for this JEP. The first one is to allow the author of a class or interface to choose which other class is allowed to extend or implement this class or interface. Second goal, to offer a syntax that will allow for a finer control over the one we have today. And third, to give the possibility to have exhaustive switch on types, which is an upcoming feature of the JDK. How can you control who can extend your classes today? In a nutshell, you have two solutions. The first one, you can forbid any extension with the final keyword. The second one, you can play with the visibility of your constructor. If you make the constructor of your class package protected, that is, without a visibility modifier, only the classes from this package can extend your class. If your application uses modules from the JDK 9, then split packages are forbidden. So a module B cannot declare classes in a package from module A. So playing with visibility allows you to control who can extend your classes. It is a way to control who extends what. It is not that great because it's not very explicit. To see it, you need to carefully analyze the code you see. You need to read between the lines. From the readability perspective, it's really not a good solution. With the sealed classes mechanism, your code is much more simple and much more clear. You can explicitly declare in the class or interface what classes have the permission to extend or implement this class. By reading this declaration, you have the list of these classes. The declaration is explicit in your code, so it's much more readable. What are the non-objectives of this JEP? First, it is not a goal to introduce in Java the notion of friend for a class, for a function, or for any kind of member. And it is not a goal to change the semantic of the final keyword for classes. This does not change. A final class is still a final class, as we have been knowing it for years. Just a quick remark on friends. What is a friend class or function? This is something you can see, for instance, in C++. In C++, a class A can declare that a given function or other class is a friend function of itself, that is, of class A. And in that case, this friend can have access to the private members of A. So the goal is not to add this notion to the Java language. If a class B can extend a sealed class A, then B can extend A, and that's it. This class B has no other rights to access the private content of class A. A sealed class is declared with the keyword sealed. So public sealed class shape or public sealed interface shape declares a sealed class or a sealed interface. You can seal a class, an abstract class, or an interface. This class or interface must declare the classes that extend it. Before we see the exact syntax, there are restrictions on the extensions. These classes must be either in the same package if you are using an unnamed module, according to the JDK 9, either in the same module if you are in a named module, according to the JDK 9. The permitted classes are declared with a permits clause. It lists the classes. Second point, a class that extends a sealed class can be one of the following: It can itself be sealed. It can be final, either explicitly, with the final keyword, or effectively. Think about records or enumerations. And it can be non-sealed. This non-sealed is a new keyword in Java that has this new syntax with an hyphen in the middle of it. And that's it. So you need to explicitly declare what is the status of a class that is permitted to extend a sealed class. Non-sealed means that this class can be freely extended. So here, the hierarchy is not closed. It can be extended through this well-shaped non-sealed class. Of course, sealed classes can also define closed hierarchies that do not allow for extension. Sealed classes have an impact on how cast, conversion, and instanceof are working. Suppose that you have an interface, I, and a class A that does not implement I. You can write some code that will check if a variable A of type A is an instance of I, and the compiler will accept that. Why? Because at runtime, you may have a class B that extends A and also implements the interface I. And that is known only at runtime. On the other hand, if the class A is final, then testing instance of I is a compiler error. Why? Because the compiler knows that an instance of A will never be an instance of I due to this final keyword. The same goes for sealed classes. If the compiler sees that A cannot be an instance of I because the I interface is sealed and the class A is not in the list of the permitted classes, then it will be able to generate an error. This code will not compile. Two more points. First, you cannot create a non-permitted implementation of a sealed type at runtime. The JVM will catch you. It can prevent such a creation. Second, two methods have been added on the class to check if this class is sealed and to get the array of the permitted classes if there are any. Well, I'm out of coffee, so that's it for today. Talk to you soon.